I think I have actually found a real potential OLED killer, and Sony showed it to me. So I recently got back from a trip to visit Sony in Tokyo, where it showed me something I have never seen before. Turns out, Sony has been working on RGB Mini-LED for 3 years now. I got to see it, and I'm here to tell you that if ever there was going to be an OLED killer, at least in the premium TV space, this is it. Now we have a backlight making independent red, green, and blue colors. And we get a couple of benefits there. For one, backlight bleeding, blooming, halo, all that stuff is going to be reduced. When it does leak, it's gonna be harder for us to see it. We're gonna be drawn more to the picture we see than the backlight that's helping to make it. It also lightens the load on the LCD panel's color filter. The less work the color filter has to do, the more brightness can actually shine through. And that's where Sony's flavor of RGB Mini-LED technology comes in. We now know that they are going to be starting mass production of these RGB Mini-LED displays this year, 2025. That means we're probably looking at RGB Mini-LED TVs from Sony in 2026. And when that happens, well, I think that's when the OLED TV story starts to shift. I know a lot of enthusiasts have been wondering what a Bravia 10 might look like. And I'm just guessing here, I could end up being wrong, but I'm betting a Bravia 10 would be an RGB Mini-LED TV, and I could not be more excited by that idea. I think that OLED has a real challenger now in the premium TV space. I don't doubt OLED's gonna continue to win award after award for years to come. But I also don't think OLED will be the slam dunk winner for best TV tech that it once was. And hey, that is a good thing. This kind of technological progress is what we need to stoke competition, because when brands compete, consumers win.